Hello viewers, in the previous classes we discussed how to calculate pH of the acidic buffer solution and basic buffer solution by using Henderson equation, right? Different types of formulas we discussed. In this lecture we are going to discuss some important problems on the buffers concept. Okay, see here, first question is 0.01 molar acetic acid is mixed with 0.005 molar calcium acetate. Okay, calculate the H plus ion concentration present in the mixture. And here, acid dissociation constant of acetic acid is provided in this problem. Okay, see here, first we have to identify which type of the solution is or what is the mixture. Okay, right? See, we have mixed 0.01 molar acetic acid with 0.005 molar calcium acetate. See here, the weak acid is mixed with a salt of the same weak acid with a strong base, so that's why this acts as a acidic buffer. Yes or no? For an acidic buffer to calculate H plus ion concentration, okay, so already we discussed this formula. What is the formula? Ka into concentration of acid by the concentration of salt. Okay, so this is the formula to calculate H plus ion concentration, right, for an acidic buffer. Yes or no? So now see here, concentrations are provided in the molarities. Remember that already I mentioned in the previous classes, we must take concentrations in the normality during the acid base calculations, whatever it may be, salt, buffer, whatever it may be, we must express the concentrations in normality only. Okay, so now see here, concentration of acetic acid equal to 10 power minus 2 molar. Okay, and concentration of calcium acetate equal to how much? 5 into 10 power minus 3 molar. Okay, but we should convert this into normality. Yes or no? We know the relation between molarity and normality. Normality equal to n factor into molarity. So no, normality equal to n factor into molarity, right? Okay, so if we convert this one into normality, see here, for acetic acid n factor is 1. Yes or no? So that's why here that is equal to 10 power minus 2 normal. Yes or no? Next, here the concentration of calcium acetate is given in molarity, and here n factor for calcium acetate is 2. Already we discussed in the previous lectures how to calculate n factor, right? N factor is 2, so that's why 2 into 5 into 10 power minus 3 normal, that equal to 10 into 10 power minus 3, that is equal to 10 power minus 2 normal. Okay, so concentration of acid is 10 power minus 2 normal, and concentration of salt is also 10 power minus 2 normal. Now substitute these two values here. So concentration of H plus ion equal to Ka is provided, 2 into 10 power minus 5 into concentration of acid, how much? 10 power minus 2. Concentration of salt, how much? 10 power minus 2. So no, so both will get cancelled. So finally we have 2 into 10 power minus 5. Okay, so this is the concentration of H plus ion. Clear? Okay, first identify which type of solution that is and write the suitable formula. Remember this one, we must express the concentrations in normalities only. Okay, so they provided in molarity, so we have converted them into the normalities. We know this relation, normality equal to n factor into molarity. Okay, clear? After simplification we are getting H plus ion concentration equal to 2 into 10 power minus 5 normal. Okay, 50 ml of 0.1 molar solution of sodium acetate and 50 ml of 0.01 molar acetic acid are mixed with each other, right? and pKa of acetic acid is 4.76. What is the pH of the buffer solution? Okay, so what are the provided information? Just write that one. Okay, so 50 ml of 0.1 molar solution of sodium acetate, CH3COONA, sodium acetate. Now it is mixed with 50 ml of 0.01 molar acetic acid. So sodium acetate is mixed with acetic acid. See, now it is a mixture of weak acid and its salt formed by the combination of a strong base. So now what is this mixture? This mixture is a acidic buffer. It is a acidic buffer. Okay, so what is the formula to calculate pH of the acidic buffer? We have discussed different types of formula, but depending upon the information provided in the question, we have to use the suitable formula to get answer in a less number of steps. Okay, see here, volume and concentration of salt and acid are provided. Yes or no? So in this case, what is the formula to calculate pH equal to pKa plus log Okay, so what is the formula here? Initial concentration into initial volume of salt by initial concentration into initial volume of acid. Okay, so this is the formula to calculate pH for this solution depending upon the information provided. Yes or no? Directly they have provided the initial volume and concentration of acid and salt. Okay, let us substitute here. pKa how much? 4.76 plus log. Okay, see here, initial concentration of salt how much? 0.1 molar, right? 0.1 into initial volume how much? 50 ml. By okay, so initial concentration of acid how much? 0.01 into initial volume of acid how much? 50 ml. Okay, so 50 will get cancelled, and here we get 4.76 plus log. Okay, so 0.1, that we can write 10 power minus 1 by 10 power minus 2. Okay, so finally here we get 4.76 plus log 10 after simplification. Yes or no? If this comes here, it does becomes 10 power plus 2. So 10 power minus 1 into 10 power plus 2, we get 10. Okay, so log 10 equal to 1, right? So if we substitute here, pH equal to 4.76 plus 1, that is equal to 5.76. So this is the pH of this buffer solution. Okay, clear? So very simple, we have discussed the different formulas depending upon the information provided. We have to use the suitable formula. Okay,